Friends, I've got a quick update on the Tinkercad sketch tool, so let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. If you've never been here before, you can simply choose sign in with Google. Our designs are saved to the cloud. This is what they look like. Today, we're going to click right here and choose create new 3D design. I like to start by naming the projects. I'm going to call this sketch stroke. Just like that, your project's saved. I do want to show you quickly, if you back out, this is what they look like. They are initially all private. Of course, you can choose to make them public when you're done. To re-enter your project, simply click Tinker This. As I said, we're going to work with the sketch tool. I'm going to bring this out and set it in a 20 by 20 grid. I like that simply because it lines up. Now, if you've never used Sketch before, it is taught right here. This updates all the time. It's full of awesome information. Make sure you check them all out. Of course, once you're done exploring, you can go back to Continue Sketch and Build. If you prefer my tutorials, this is the playlist that'll get you there. So today I'm going to start by drawing a square. Just click, click. Notice I'm making it 20 by 20 on every side. Just snap this into place. Now, a new feature last week was to be able to copy and paste. Control C and Control V. I'm going to move these over here, and then I'm going to do Control V again, and I'm going to move it over here as well. I'm going to space these out a little bit better, just so there's a gap in between them so that I can show you what I need to show you. When we click on these shapes, we have now got a tool down here called Stroke Settings. If we turn on the Stroke Width, I'm going to just leave it as default. There's two. I'm going to leave it as the inside. And then I wanted to show you the difference between Sharp. And then this one, we're going to switch to the same two, but we're going to make it round. And notice right now that has no difference. And then I'm going to click on this one. And once again, two. And we're going to make this one the bevel. Now, when these finish, they still all look the same. Well, let's see what happens if we go down here and change this to the center line. Bingo! There is the rounded outside that you needed to see to prove that it was round. Once again, click on this one, switch to the center line, and check it out, there is the beveled edge. I'll zoom in so you can see the difference again. This has a bevel or a chiseled corner. This one has the rounded corner. There you go, friends. That is the main trick. Had to switch to center line to see the difference. With those created, I'm gonna just move the spacing a little bit. Let's hit finish sketch. And now we've got a much better view of what the corner looks like, the round looks like, and the beveled looks like. So friends, I'm never here to waste your minutes. I do want to say thank you to Andy for the question. And now we know the difference when using Sketch and the stroke settings between straight corners, round corners, and beveled corners. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I do also want to quickly say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We passed 200 members. There's a fantastic messaging area, and of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.